Good morning. Who sends false prophets? Jeremiah 14, verses 10 to 16 now. Thus says the Lord to this people, thus they have loved to wander. They have not restrained their feet. Therefore, the Lord does not accept them. He will remember their iniquity now and punish their sins. Then the Lord said to me, do not pray for this people for their good. When they fast, I will not hear their cry. And when they offer burnt offering and grain offering, I will not accept them. But I will consume them by the sword, by the famine, and by the pestilence. Then I said, ah, Lord God, behold, the prophets say to them, you shall not see the sword, nor shall you have famine, but I will give you assured peace in this place. And the Lord said to me, the prophets prophesy lies in my name. I have not sent them, commanded them, nor spoken to them. They prophesy to you a false vision, divination, a worthless thing, and the deceit of their heart. Therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the prophets who prophesy in my name, whom I did not send, and who say sword and famine shall not be in this land, by sword and famine those prophets shall be consumed, and the people to whom they prophesy shall be cast in the streets of Jerusalem because of the famine and the sword, and they will have no one to bury them, them nor their wives, their sons, nor their daughters, for I will pour their wickedness on them. So they prophesy the deceit of their own heart. God is very plain. I have not sent them. They're self-appointed. God warns Jeremiah not to pray for this people for their good. Not yet, because they're unrepentant. Yes, they fast, they pray, they give their offerings, they sing, but their heart is not right. They are not surrendered to him. This is superficial stuff. This is surface stuff. God sees through it, of course. These are fake responses. They haven't returned to him. Now, Jeremiah points out, you know, their peace and safety message. And God affirms that in response, the very thing they say won't happen, God's going to make sure that's what happens to them. That's what happens for false prophets. Yeah, they're going to really get it. And I think the other piece is quite interesting, too. What about the people? These people that they prophesy to are going to die. Their bodies are going to lay in the streets. They won't even be buried. What's that about? Why are they punished? Well, because they were called to test the prophets. See, what's going on here is these people are just as superficial as the false prophets. The prophets are prophesying out of the deceit of their own heart. And why are they doing it? Because they're making merchandise of this. The people, well, that's what the people want to hear. The people have itching ears. They want to hear false prophecies. The people are false. The people have deceit in their hearts. And so for people who have deceit in their hearts, they will appoint false prophets to themselves, and they will listen to them and hear them and carry right on because their heart's not right. So these people aren't ready to repent yet. They're not there. After all that God has done for them, they're still not there. See, the spirit of the false prophets found an answering chord in the hearts of this false people. They're not on God's side yet. This is a warning for us because God does not call us to prophesy falsely or preach smooth things just because that seems like it's the thing to do in this hour. Of course, that's the thing it seems to do, but it's not the thing to do. And so for God's people need to test the prophets. They need to test the preachers. They need to compare it to what the Bible says and hold on tight to what's true, what's according to this book. And that's the way they can minister to their own apostles, their own prophets, their own pastors, their own spiritual leaders. And it'll be good for them, and good for the can, good for the bottle, as they say. It's good for the church when we hold each other accountable. So conference presidents and theology professors, they shouldn't just get a free pass. Let's go by the word. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, your people lost their way, and that's what we're reading about here in Jeremiah, a lesson for us. Help us to learn from it and not just repeat it again. So please, Lord, help us to be in the Word, understanding the Word, and help us to hear your messengers and be able to tell the true ones from the false ones. Please help us, Lord, with the deceit of our own hearts. Please, Lord Jesus, reach down and help us with this. We ask in Jesus' name, amen. So God says of false prophets, I have not sent them. So they're mostly bottom feeders. People tolerate them. And in fact, the people are strengthening them. May we not be that people. Instead, may we be a Bible people. God be with you today.